fall, I chose to do this research and applied for this PhD position in the bioorganic synthesis group for the projects being linked to biological processes or to some kind of disease, and that attracted me most. Next to that, this particular research I did myself had a wide variety of different chemistries, like sugar chemistry, peptides, or protein chemistry, and even nucleic acid or DNA, RNA kind of chemistries, which makes it quite a wide kind of research, which attracted me most. Most exciting discoveries, most probably the synthesis of these poly-ADP ribose polymers, which has never been done before, required a lot of effort to get so far and to make it successful. So I was able to make it for the first time ever, besides Nature, of course. And I got it also published in a really nice journal, which, well, made it really complete. Yeah. So for being an organic chemist, the most favorite spot has to be the fume hood, so in the lab, where all the magic happens, where all the experiments have been done. Some successful, a lot of failures as well. And the labs in general are, of course, the place to be as an organic chemist. So that was for sure the best spot for me to be during the PhD. I think the greatest challenge, but probably this is for every PhD, has to be when you have failures, when you have to go back to the drawing board, start all over again, revisit your plans, feel like you lost a lot of time, and keep on going, keep on pushing for it. So especially endurance during a PhD and coping with the failures is one of the biggest challenges for me during my PhD.